that left 3 men dead, 1 wounded. No arrests yet, and federal authorities are reportedly stepping in to mediate. O.J. Simpson's murder trial resumes today. Cato Kaelin will be back on the stand. And tonight, right here on News Channel 7, you'll be able to watch the Academy Award presentations. The program starts at 9. We'll have a preview on Eyewitness News at noon. Now, stay tuned for AM Buffalo with Brian Cale and Linda Pellegrino.
Welcome to our Monday morning edition of AM Buffalo. Not an ordinary Monday. This is our Academy Awards edition of AM Buffalo, coming to you live from News Channel 7 studios downtown. I'm John Summers. Let's have a nice welcome for Brian Cale and Linda Pellegrino.
Said if we get 60 people, I'm going to dress up.
And look at you!
Well, it's Oscar night. Wow. I thought I'd try to look the part, you
know? My goodness, everybody is so festive here today because you're going to help out some of our models from Personal Best.
Yep.
Oh, you should see the outfits we have for
John and I are going to be escorts and for a couple of these young ladies this morning, and Miss Buffalo's here, and we're going to do a great recipe. You ever had fresh tuna?
No, I never have.
Well, tuna does not come in a can. It swims in the sea.
But I don't know anything about it.
And this is totally different. And Chris and my Wagner's here, and we're going to do it, and you're going to love it. It's a great, great recipe, so we're going to have fun with that this morning.
Oh, Ken Brown is here. He's going to help us pick the right plants for putting out in our garden. You know, if you start with a really good seedling or a little plant, you're halfway there. We're going to talk about a lot of the things that are out on the markets.
I'm going to get one of those things. I saw it on TV. It comes in a 15-foot roll, and you unroll it. And it supposedly has 10,000 seeds in it, and you do nothing but water it.
I was going to ask him about the garden weasel.
Show us how green our thumbs are, huh?
So Ken is here.
And a lot about the Oscars this morning, and some great Oscar fashions, because it is tonight, of course. And I got to tell you, a year from now, we'll be talking about a movie that I saw this weekend, Dolores Claiborne, based on the Stephen King novel. And Kathy Bates, going to have another Oscar nomination. Great film. Go see it. You'll love it.
It's funny. I felt the same way after seeing Bullets Over Broadway, and I had the opportunity to interview Diane Wiest, and I sat down with her.
And you called
She thought I was just kind of flattering. I said, I'm telling you. I said, I know these things. I bet you're going to be up for an Oscar. She said, no. If I could find that tape, I will play it for you tomorrow, especially if she wins. And she's got a really good chance of winning Best Supporting Actress.
Yeah. Good pick.
There's a lot of stuff going
good
on.
Good pick. Well, anyway, it's a busy morning, and you're going to grab your sunglasses.
I'm going to head upstairs.
Okay.
Because we are going to have a kind of a preview of our own Oscar fashions. What if you had an opportunity to go to the Oscars? What would you wear? What's appropriate? Well, seeing some of the stars, you'd never know what was really appropriate. So we're going to be talking about that this morning, because tonight all the stars will be shining in quest for that coveted little statuette. Now that means millions and millions of people will be watching. Designers, actresses will pull out all the stops to out-sparkle the competition. What would you wear if you were invited? We sure can give you some guidelines about some great formal wear. Susan Mackay is with us from Personal Best, and she brought along a few fabulous formals. Wow! I'm leaving the show. I cannot sit on the same sofa with you.
Look at you!
It's so large that you can wear it.
Oh my gosh!
How's that?
Gosh,
if I was going, I suppose I'd wear something like this.
This is fantastic.
This is like Glinda the Good Witch. From The Wizard of Oz. It's incredible. I wore it for Miss Buffalo on Saturday night, and everybody said, well, you know, you could bring the contestants out from underneath the dress.
It's
just wonderful. It's
different. I
remember
one year when Bette Midler was hosting, she came out in a huge ball gown, and the whole audience erupted. I bet you didn't think you could overdress for this event. And it was the funniest thing.
And it really is the night to overdress if you're going to do it, because everybody wants attention. Mm-hmm. And they have the best bodies in the country out there in Hollywood, so they can show them off. And we brought all kinds of dresses to do
now,
that today.
Now, we're going to show you some of the dresses that Susan bought. But for some of the actresses who are going tonight, a lot of them, as soon as the big designers know they're going, they offer them dresses.
They do.
So a lot of the looks that you're going to see tonight are the designers saying, please wear my dress tonight.
Yeah.
I've got something just for you. And that way they know they won't kind of see themselves coming and going up and down the stage.
And I think a lot of those dresses reflect the personality of the actresses. And then, of course, the tuxedos, the personalities of the males. So we'll have to check it out tonight at 9 o'clock.
Okay.
Yeah?
In the meantime, get ready, everybody, because we're going
to
the Oscars. Or we'll look as good as if we were going.
Hollywood comes to Buffalo. And our first model is wearing a wonderful baby doll dress, and she's accompanied by a great-looking guy.
This escort.
We all know him and love him, Brian, in his own tuxedo. This is Karen, and this, you know, the baby doll style that we've seen in just everyday wear. They're now transitioning to evening wear. This has jet beads with a black chiffon skirt. And it's now in formal wear in all different colors. This is from Cachet.
Wonderful.
Isn't that pretty?
And you can see how good this would look full length, and it looks great in cocktail
length.
Yes,
it does, especially if you have the legs for it, and she does.
Those little tiny sleeves. Beautiful. Mm-hmm.
John.
Oh, my.
John brings down Debbie from Bonwood Tellers. This is
look at this.
Silver sequins from shoulder to ankle. And again, very sexy, shimmery. It's a V-neck gown from Bonwood Teller at Walden Galleria. Isn't that pretty?
Wow.
And you'll see young women going to the prom in dresses like this, too.
No kidding.
Oh, yeah. They
really?
Wear everything. So Hollywood goes to the prom, too.
Wow.
Isn't that great looking?
I wonder at the Oscar season if they don't call each other to find out, just to make sure they're not wearing something too similar.
There have been repeats, though. Mm-hmm. You've seen that. So I guess they get very careful about that. And some people, I think, wear dresses that are not always flattering to their figures.
No.
Just to make a statement.
I think that's why half the people watch the Oscars.
Now, this is one model that can wear this kind of a sheath. This is, again, from the Bonwood Teller store. It's a mini sheath with notched front. Midnight blue is the color, but notice that when it shimmers in the light, you can see green in there.
Oh, yes, it's
isn't
very,
that great
it's like
looking?
A rainbow.
With the nice looking straps on the back.
Wow.
But mini, mini, mini. So you're going to see everything from very short to very long at the Oscars.
Wow, look at that.
Don't you love it?
Got legs, let me tell you.
She has the longest, thinnest legs I know of. This is Dave in an Alexander Julian from Tuxedo Junction. And what you'll notice about men's dressing is the vested look and the bow tie, which comes in all different patterns and designs. This is a paisley, red and black. And it's a three-button front. Very handsome.
Very David. Jack Nicholson. Mm,
I think so.
Absolutely devastating.
This is
like a Gina Davis kind of a dress.
She always is one of the best-looking actresses at the Oscars every year. This is a black velvet sheath trimmed with crystal and organza side panels, highlighted with Venise at the bodice and at the hip bone.
Isn't that
beautiful? That's
Tracy. Wow.
Black and white, just gorgeous. Very traditional, very classic. I could see Grace Kelly in something like this if you were looking back.
I do see some more colors. I remember last year everybody was in black.
Yeah.
Everybody.
And now I think you'll still see a lot of black, but you'll also see a lot of red and white. And this new silver that they're coming out
with.
That's
the new hot color.
Yes,
silver.
It is. And this is a very pretty dress. If a Marilyn Monroe lookalike was at the Oscars, she'd probably wear something like this. This is a spectacular black halter cocktail dress with a swing skirt from Seasons Bridal. And it has a beaded lace applique accent at the waist. Isn't that pretty?
That is very
Kelly
classic.
Pino. Miss Erie Niagara.
Well, hello, Miss Erie Niagara. Hello. It's beautiful.
Isn't that nice?
Very flattering.
Very nice. And Justin, who looks very dapper in his mustard vest with matching bow tie and one button front from Tuxedo Junction. Again, Alexander Julian is the designer. Isn't that pretty?
That is beautiful.
Pretty.
Very,
he's
very
a good-looking guy.
My son would say, he's handsome, Mom, not beautiful.
Very. And tall,
yes.
6'5".
Wow, and you can just imagine your son or you're like you said, your kids going to the prom in some of these, really, in just a matter of weeks.
And they can be found right here in Buffalo.
Wow. And where's your dress
from? This is from Seasons Bridal, and they have this wonderful array of evening gowns and even cocktail-length dresses. So.
Well, you look fantastic.
Thank you.
You are all ready to go. All
just
you need
fly
to
me
do?
Out to Hollywood.
That's
I'm ready
right.
to go.
And of course, out there it gets going a little bit early, about 6 o'clock.
Yes, it does.
Our time, it's on at 9 o'clock, and I think Barbara Walters will be on before then.
Yes, she has her special on every year,
with
which is very, very exciting to watch. Yes, and I have an Oscar party every year, so I have a whole bunch of people coming over to my house, and we have a great time watching the Oscars.
So you've picked, and in your mind, you know who Verdi's going to pick up the best.
I definitely, because I've seen a lot of the movies, know who I would like
all
to
right.
see win.
You want to give us a little?
I think that Nigel Hawthorne should get it for Madness of King George. And I know he's not a commercial favorite, but his acting talent is wonderful.
Okay.
So we'll see if he gets it.
Forrest Gump for Best Picture? Everybody
probably, again, a commercial
Forrest.
Favorite. I think it's a fine movie, but there are lots of good movies out there, too.
Okay,
so
Susan.
We'll see.
We thank you for
thank
getting
you.
All gussied up
yes.
for us this morning. And, of course, all our models from Personal Best. Oh, the Oscars tonight, folks.
Can't
we'll
wait.
We'll see what those folks
one of my favorite shows.
have in mind to wear tonight. We'll be right back.
with us. Coming up on the show, Christopher Wagner is cooking up a great grilled tuna recipe. You're going to love it.
What a team! FWS and Pennsylvania House. Bring distinction to your home's interior with beautiful Pennsylvania House furniture, now exclusively at FWS. For the first time in Western New York, FWS combines deep discount and special order on the famous quality and style of Pennsylvania House. Save up to 50%. Pennsylvania House. It's what you wanted all along, and now you can afford it.
Dress up your home for less FWS.
Don't lie about your age. Defy it.
Defy it.
Defy it.
Did you know makeup can make you look older by settling into fine lines? Revlon age-defying makeup has color particles wrapped in moisturizers, so the coverage floats above fine lines, stays virtually line-free. You stay younger looking all day. Revlon age-defying makeup.
Don't lie about your age. Defy it.
Revlon.
America's best contacts and eyeglasses will beat any eyewear price. Daily wear soft contacts or two pair of great eyeglasses complete, including the eye exam, $39.99. At America's Best, get two pair of high fashion eyeglasses or a pair of contacts, $39.99, including the eye exam. Call America's Best contacts and eyeglasses now.
Here's a Leach Murad. Great price, right? Wrong. At Silo, every item we carry is at least 10% less. Silo will beat any local competitor's current advertised price by 10% or more. That's right, any ad, any commercial. No matter how low the competition goes, Silo will be lower by at least 10%. Any appliance, any TV, any camcorder, any stereo. Silo will be at least 10% lower. Because at Silo, you just can't lose.
They can't cope with their co-workers.
I'm just sick of the way he acts.
I can't work with her.
Are you firing her today?
Next, Ricky Lake. Monday morning at 11 on News Channel 7.
There was just a ton of things going on this weekend, running even through tonight. And one of the things happening yesterday was our regular New York State lottery draw. The daily number came in 490 and the win for 3183. Here's pick 10, 5, 11, 13, 15, 21, 25, 26, 28, 36, 37, 39, 41, 50, 51, 60, 61, 65, 69, 72, and finally 76. And I wish everybody best of luck.
You know, our days and nights may still be on the chilly side, but avid gardeners are already starting seeds and scouring nurseries for newer and better varieties of flowers, vegetables, and trees. What should you know, though, before turning over that first shovel full of dirt? Well, we'll call Ken Brown in and take your phone calls, because there's a lot of new stuff out on the market, Ken, including tools and a lot of the things that Brian and I were talking about at the top of the show. Good morning. Have you done anything in your own garden yet?
Well, I've done a little transplanting and things. We've had an early break on the season.
So
some things have happened ahead of time. So we're going to talk about that after we talk about some new varieties. But yeah, there's some things that can be done out there.
All right, so start us off.
Well, we've got some pictures of some new varieties that are out this year. They're all America winners. And the first one is called Celebrity Chiffon Morn. It's a petunia.
Oh, sounds so pretty.
Yeah, it's sort of a chiffon color with a white throat on it that is really nice. It gets up to about 12 inches high, and it bushes to 12 inches across. I think gardeners that have not tried petunias in a couple years should try them again, because the breeders have done a better job of growing plants that grow in nice forms and shapes, rather than the scraggly old types that we used to get with petunias.
Is that an annual?
Yes, these are all annuals.
You'll have to put them in every year.
Right.
Okay.
The next one is also a petunia, but it's a little bit different in its growth habit. It's called Purple Wave, and it spreads. It really spreads out. In fact, the directions on it say to plant it a foot apart in your rows, but 3 feet between rows. It sort of grows like a ground cover, and it spreads out to 4 feet long in terms of areas. So if you've got a little hill maybe that you want to cover, or if you're growing over the edge of a stone wall or something where you want an annual to crawl, Purple Wave might be a real interesting. Again, it's a petunia. Again, it's a different type and style of growth pattern, things that gardeners might be interested
in. Now, does it take a lot of sun?
All petunias should be planted in full sunshine.
Okay.
Get as much sun as you can.
Okay.
The next one is called Indian Summer, and it's a Rudbeckia or a Black-Eyed Susan. And I think this is the best of the bunch. The flowers on this Black-Eyed Susan will get 9 inches across. And I just love Black-Eyed Susans anyway. They're yellow with a dark center. They're brilliant in the later parts of the summer. It's a beautiful plant. And this one's called Indian Summer. Hopefully it should be available on the Garden Center shelf. Again, it's an annual. It's not a perennial Black-Eyed Susan. But I'm really excited about this one because it should give a good show. Yellow always is very intense in its color, you know, and it just shows up great in the landscape.
Now, if you were to buy these, you can start them in the basement right now?
All of these probably could be started indoors now. In most cases, I think gardeners are probably better off to start them, to buy them in the Garden Center rather than start them from seed.
I see.
But they should be started as small plants, and they'll be available in the garden.
All right. What
one
have
more.
You?
I got
oh,
one,
yeah,
more.
One more.
And this
oh,
is
good.
Not a new variety this year, but it's Big Beef. It was a tomato that was an All-American winner last year. Did great. Was hard to find on the Garden Center shelf. I'm hoping it's easier to find this year. A super tomato. I grew it myself, and I just loved it. So look for Big Beef.
Now, is that good for sauce, or is that good for soups or salads that have a lot of liquid inside?
It's sort of a general-purpose tomato. It's good for just about anything. It's not a real meaty tomato, but it's not a really juicy tomato either. Just a general-purpose sandwich slicing type of tomato.
Big Beef.
Big Beef. I love
that.
The name.
Yeah. Okay. All right. What have you brought us here, Ken?
Okay. Because we've had such an early break in the season, it's time that we can move some things along. And the first one is the big guy over here, the tall guy. This happens to be a white fir, but it's just an example of a woody type of plant material that we might be moving at this time. Small trees, roses, shrubs, while they're dormant and before they've leafed out, now's the time to dig these things out of the ground and move them. Once the buds start to break, and you can see all the little buds at the ends of the shoots here, once those start to break, it gets a lot more difficult to transplant these things successfully. But while those buds are nice and tight now, you can move those.
Now, how big will this get? How much room should you allot?
This is a white fir, which eventually, or at least out on the Pacific coast where it grows naturally, it will get to 100 feet tall. So
these are
big trees.
Needs a lot of room.
This is for our Christmas tree farm. And so, then you're spaced from about 6 feet
it's
apart.
It's tough to put the star on top, though.
Yes, it is.
Big ladder. Brian, out to you.
Okay, we got some gardeners out here. Good morning.
Good morning. I have two clematis vines, and they've been in the ground 2 years, and they grew to a height of about 8 feet. Now, I looked at them yesterday in the sunlight, and they're budding the whole length of the vine. And I was just wondering about pruning. Should I prune it back? Will I get better blooms if I cut it back, or just let it bloom where it's at?
It probably won't make any difference. What time of year does it bloom?
It blooms probably in July.
Okay. Any of the summer bloomers, you can do as much pruning on them as you want to at this time of year. And they'll come out, they'll grow back, and they will bloom. Some gardeners will cut them all the way to the ground in the springtime, and they'll grow all the way back up. Some like to have the top foliage on them to begin with, so they'll just maybe pick out some dead stuff, thin them out a little bit, and prune them like that. It doesn't matter. It's really how you want the plant to look right away, because it'll bloom this summer either way.
Now, my clematises look real good if I don't touch the old dead stuff, because it uses that to crawl back
to
on, and
crawl on.
They really fill out wide. I guess it depends on the variety you've got.
Yeah, and it depends on the location and how it's growing, where it's growing, what sort of fits that spot. If you're growing it up a fence post, sometimes it's easier to cut it all the way down and let it grow up from the bottom.
Isn't that a fun plant? I love clematis.
Yeah,
it's great. Okay, to the phone we go. Good morning.
Hi, I have a question about tulip bulbs.
Tulip bulbs.
Okay.
They started to sprout in my basement last year, and I don't know what to do with them now.
Well, I would, if you're ready for them to start flowering shortly, and I would think you would, maybe for Easter or something like that, I would bring them out, get them on a sunny window still, start to water them, and they should have poked through the top of the surface of the soil already. And just grow them on in as much light as you can, and cool temperatures tends to keep them shorter too. It's a little tough for a homeowner to force tulips, mostly because of the temperature ranges. But I'd get them out and get them started.
Now, you know what we learned about tulips in our yard is that the deer love them.
Yeah.
So if you don't have a fence around them, you're going to find them all nibbled. But the deer don't like daffodils.
Yeah.
So we put daffodils in instead, and they're growing like crazy. Brian.
Yeah, I was put some flowers in or some vegetables last year, and rabbits got to them. Mm. Is there any good ways of getting rid of animals besides fencing?
Yeah, fencing is by far the most foolproof, because then you can completely keep them away. But fencing looks kind of silly around a flower garden where you're hiding all the flowers. Try some of the repellents. Try things like hinder or therium. You can try other homeowner type things like mothballs. The repellents, sometimes they work great and sometimes they don't. I think one of the keys is starting early. Don't wait until the rabbits find them, but start the repellents right away so that the rabbits don't find them to begin with, rather than after they found them and chewed half of them down trying to save the second half.
Okay, we have some tools we're going to go over, too. We'll take one more call first, though. Good morning.
Hi. Well, you answered my question. I have a dog that urinates on certain plants. So you answered my question.
And,
away from urinating on plants, you said mothballs, you can do the same thing?
Yeah, keep them away either with mothballs, or there are some dog and cat repellents available in the garden centers. They're, again, a fence of some kind or something like that.
It's bad habit. You know, you have to keep them away because once they develop that habit, that's it.
Yeah.
All right, Ken.
Okay, if we're going to transplant these things, there's a lot of tools we can use. We can use different types of spades. We can use trowels. We can use a spading fork, which is this kind here. Anything to lift the plant out of the ground. And if we're going to divide it, it doesn't matter if some of the root falls off. If we're going to just move it to a different spot, the more soil we keep on the root ball, probably the faster it's going to establish and the better it's going to take off. These are a couple different perennials that we've got here. If you look really close at this guy, this is a Siberian iris.
Well, you have to look close.
And actually, this one is probably transplanted in the fall, but you can see the little green. You see the little green shoots starting to come up here?
Mm-hmm.
This plant is just about the right size. I wouldn't have dug this up if I wasn't bringing it in today because it's a fairly small clump, and it's going to grow this year, and it's going to bloom fine. When they get to be this size of the daylilies that are here, and they're packed way too close together, this clump hasn't bloomed in our garden for years, so we're going to divide it up into different sections of probably 5 to 6 shoots apiece, and just move it to a different spot in the garden and separate them out and see if we can't get those.
It's a good thing you're here, because I would have thought that's just grass. I'm serious. I mean, it looks like grass.
And unfortunately, we can't divide this today. I was going to do that on air, but I left it in the back of my truck last night, and it froze solid, so we can't. But you would normally use something like a knife, just a sharp knife, to cut them apart, or if you physically can pull them apart, sometimes you can do that. But something just to cut. Don't worry about injuring roots. And people get kind of squeamish about cutting them apart. Mm-hmm. Cut them apart into sections the size that you want, and then move them.
What, no garden weasel or claw? I would
have thought
that's
for
the
this
first
project.
One you would have had.
Not for this project.
Brian?
Well, first of all, we have a solution for the man with the rabbit. What you do is you get a scarecrow, you dress him up as a magician, you put him in the garden. The rabbit thinks he's going to have to live in a top hat. He'll stay away. It works. Your question.
Yes. My backyard is so full of mole runs that my above-ground pool is going to be an in-ground at any minute. Is there any way to get rid of moles?
Oh, I wished we had a good answer for moles. There are not any really good answers for moles. To a certain extent, I think we have to live with them. In the springtime, you rake over the tunnels, you reseed them, and you let them go, and they tend to diminish as the weather gets drier. You can try the X-Lax tablets down in the tunnels. You can try the Chewy
Fruit
Gum down in the tunnels.
Does it do to the moles what it does to people?
Apparently.
Oh,
I'm not really sure what it does to moles. Bleach-soaked rags down in the tunnels, mothballs in the tunnels.
What about grubs? If you take care of the grubs, isn't that what the moles eat?
That's what we used to do, and when we could use chloridane and it killed both the grubs and the earthworms, then the moles would leave. The chemicals we use nowadays don't kill the earthworms, so instead of feeding on the grubs, they just switch to the earthworms, so it doesn't work as well.
Hey, this lady tried the X-Lax.
Yes, I did. I just noticed there was a lot more mole runs. I think they're moving.
They're moving faster, Ken. That's what they're doing. Yeah.
Well, what do you expect a mole to do but run when you give them that stuff?
Did she say mole runs or the moles had the runs?
I don't know. You get rid of the moles, but the smell, well, it's a whole different deal. Good morning. Go ahead.
Hi, I'm planning a summer perennial garden, and I was wondering if there's any tubers or that can be left in the ground through the winter that wouldn't have to be dug up.
Well, the idea of most perennials is to leave them in the ground. You don't have to dig them up. When you're going to divide them like you might these daylilies or other plants, it depends on whether they're going to need it or not. If they've grown too close together or too thick, or if they don't bloom as well as they have, or the center has died out, that might be every 3 to 5 years, 7 years, 10 years. Some don't never need division at all. So most perennials are meant to put in the ground and stay there, maybe with just a little tending now and then. You don't have to move them around or dig them up every year.
Okay, thank you. And of course, for people who do want to get out there and get their gardens, you know, I guess, is this a good time to add fertilizer as soon as you can turn the dirt once it defrosts?
Yep. Anytime in April, sometime early May, mm-hmm. when plants are going to start growing, fertilizer is going to be needed when the plants are starting to grow. And so that's the time you want to get. We're a little bit away from that because we've had such an early break, but we're coming up on it.
And you can't tell everybody's just so anxious to get out there. Ken, thanks so much for being with us. Next time we will do the claw on the garden weasel, we promise. We'll be right back.
Cable has some beautiful decorating ideas for window treatments. She uses dried flowers.
You know, last year a lot of people missed 9X's free call waiting hookup, like my Aunt Sophie. So this year I'm calling her myself. Oh, well, once again, Aunt Sophie misses out. But you don't have to. Call 1-800-THE-TONE for your free call waiting hookup. See, people call and you won't get a busy signal, and you won't pay a connection charge. Ooh, our first call. Yeah, that's right. We'll connect you for free while this offer lasts. No, no, no service visit. No, I can't give you Aunt Sophie's phone number. Probably wouldn't get through anyway. So, call waiting lets you take another phone call while you're on the line, so important phone calls can get through. Like, when Mom has car trouble. Or, when the bus leaves, without little Petey. So, don't miss out this year. For your free call waiting hookup, call 1-800-THE-TONE. That's 1-800-THE-TONE. And if you see Aunt Sophie, tell her. Ooh.
Doing it all over again. Starting this Thursday, RV Show 95, the big one.
Part two.
Bigger and better than before. More RV units all under one roof inside the Niagara Falls Convention Center. This Thursday through Sunday, see a wider variety of RV manufacturers and a wider variety of recreational vehicles. Financing available at the show. It's RV Show 95, the big one.
Part two.
Niagara Falls Convention Center this Thursday through Sunday. Another official RV show of the Western New York RV Dealers Association.
It was the toughest decision I ever had to make. We've cared for Mom here in our home for so many years. Now she needs professional medical attention. But who do you trust to take care of the one you love?
At the McGuire Group, we understand how tough it is to choose a nursing facility. That's why we take the time to meet with you to answer all your questions.
Now I know that choosing the McGuire Group was the right decision.
The McGuire Group, recognized for excellence in quality care.
Stand by. When you hear 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Look who's coming to News Channel 7.
I've got Oscar fever.
Okay, so it's just for one night. But hey, we couldn't be happier. Dave Letterman is hosting the Academy Awards. It's David
Letterman. And as you know, runners-up will receive one of my old hair pieces.
Tonight at 9 on News Channel 7.
Good morning. We're taking a look at one of our AM Buffalo community calendars. The East Aurora American Field Service will have their goods and services auction coming up Friday, March 31st, 7:30 p.m. at Fireman's Field on Pine Street. And that's in East Aurora. If you have any questions, call this number, 655-4652.
Welcome back. Music critics around the world have applauded the talents of our next guest. In fact, one Scottish newspaper called guitarist Pierre Bensouzard one of the greatest instrumentalists in the second half of the 20th century. His first recording at age 17, by the way, won the best folk album at the 1976 Montreux Jazz Festival. His latest is called Woo Wee. Please welcome to AM Buffalo, Pierre Bensouzard.
Tous les oiseaux qui
chantons pas de la même mère. Ne sont pas tous pour un seul chasseur et mamie pour un seul serviteur. Elle me fit d'un bouquet. Je ne sais ce qu'il signifie, si c'est d'amour ou de regret, ou bien pour me donner mon congé. C'est ce qu'il signifie, si c'est d'amour ou de regret, ou bien pour me donner mon congé.
That's beautiful, and your vocal range is amazing as well.
That's early in the morning, though.
You, of course, you live in Paris. You're from Paris.
I am from North Africa. I was born in Algeria.
I grew up
in Paris.
Yeah.
And now I live in a champagne country. I drink a lot of champagne every day.
Good for you.
Yes, it's good. Yeah.
I know you studied piano as a youngster, and did you self-taught on the guitar?
I took 4 years of classical piano training with a private teacher in the suburb of Paris. And accidentally, I came across a guitar at school and fell in love with the guitar and with singing and with playing instrumental music on guitar.
I was going to say, could you tell right away that you had a special passion for this instrument? It's beautiful the way you play, especially.
Thank you very much.
Yeah. Could you tell right away?
I had to play music somehow. It could have been an accordion. It could have been anything. Maybe not a wind instrument. That's something which has to do with the air you breathe and everything, but singing to me...
I tried that. It's tough.
It's tough, yeah. So singing is a bit like playing a wind instrument, and playing the guitar is a bit like having a little orchestra at your disposal.
Well, your sound is interesting because it's kind of eclectic. There's a little of... I know you've won awards with folk music, but you do jazz and classical.
Yeah, well, you know, I really love music, and to me, they're all that much separated and into different genres. They're all the same notes, just played differently, you know.
You had, by the way, a very nice crowd at the Marquee last night, very well received. You have some fans, obviously, in Buffalo and Western New York as well.
Yes, well, I hope so.
Yeah. That music, that number you did, is that an original?
It's an original. It's a traditional poem from the 18th century, which I read once and fell totally in love. It was not done on purpose, but it was called The Garden of Love.
Mm. Is that on the new CD, on the new recording?
No, it's a CD before.
CD before. You've done five, I think, right?
Six.
Six now.
Yeah.
Well, it's nice to have you with us in Buffalo, and congratulations on a great performance. And you're doing very well. Thank you.
Thank you.
Here, Ben Suzan, AM Buffalo. We'll be right back.
Coit gets it 100% clean.
I need 100% clean, so I called Coit.
Coit's your choice. Sale is on now.
I don't know how they do it. I just know they get my carpet clean, they get my upholstery clean, they get it Coit clean.
Call now and save up to 30% or $105.
Coit clean is clean I can be proud of.
It's your choice. Take whichever saves you more.
Experience you can trust.
trust McCoy.
The average family has this much food waste at the end of an average week. The family with the InSinkErator disposer has this much. InSinkErator, the world's most preferred disposer.
All bets are off when Luther's winnings make him a loser.
Hayden fired me.
Coach.
Catch the Coach now at 4:30 weekdays on News Channel 7.
Linda's Hair, styled by Santangelo's, with locations throughout Western New York. Brian's clothing provided by JCPenney's men's department in the Walden Galleria. Linda's wardrobe furnished by Cache in the Walden Galleria. Guests of AM Buffalo and WKBW-TV stay at the beautiful waterfront Buffalo Hilton Hotel, featuring fine dining in Justine's, the only restaurant in Buffalo to receive the Four Diamond Award. Limousine service provided by Giorgio's. Call 683-7455 for service in Western New York.
Finally, if you wear glasses or contacts, Value Vision has the best values in Western New York. Get three pair of eyeglasses for only $99 and choose from every frame on display in the store. Plus, you can share this offer with family or friends. Remember, at Value Vision, you choose from every frame on display. Not just selected styles or limited selections, you get three pair of quality brand name eyeglasses for just $99 every day. That's Value Vision.
My brother's a no-nonsense guy, and his head's got to ache pretty bad for him to admit it. But when the pain lasts longer than Tylenol, and you've tried the Advil, you say, I give, and see what your doctor recommends.
Introducing Aleve, a non-prescription strength of Anaprox, a fast-acting form of the medicine in naproxen. Only Aleve has 8 to 12-hour dosing. It lasts longer than extra-strength Tylenol. Advil isn't stronger. New Aleve.
As tough as he is, he's still my little brother.
New Aleve. All day strong, all day long.
Riding Metro is cheaper than parking gas and tolls, and with Commuter Check, it's even more economical. It's the employee benefit I use every day.
For Commuter Check information, call Metro 855-7222.
We're real sorry that every day can't be Oscar Day here on AM Buffalo, but Brian and I would get awfully tired of these tuxes after a while. But listen, we have just as good a time tomorrow as we're going to have today, so get to your phone after 11:30 this morning and call us at 840-7868. We have a lot of great shows coming up. Make a reservation. Bring lots of your loud friends, too.
What you're looking at is fresh tuna. I know what you're thinking. Where's the can? No. Fresh tuna is one of the great delicacies, and this morning we're going to show you how to pan sear it, and we're going to serve it in a salad. And Krista Van Wagner's here from Curly's with all the know-how. Good morning.
Hello.
Nice to have you with us. And we're going to talk a little bit about Best of Lackawanna, which is coming up too. But this is for people who've never had fresh tuna. It is so good.
Beautiful. It is so different. And the one thing that is so different about it, when you order it, Brian, you can order it cooked just like a steak. The texture, the consistency of it,
yep.
You can order it
so
medium rare.
So a little pink inside is fine.
Yeah,
in fact, that's the best.
Exactly. So if the chef serves it to you a little undercooked, don't send it back. Try it.
It's supposed to be like that. But the texture is not like fish. The texture is like
pork. Yes, exactly. Yeah. Almost like a steak, I'd say.
Okay, well, we'll do it. And I know you're going to put it in a salad. And let's start.
Well, what I've done today... being Curly's, I've marinated it in my Jamaican jerk sauce.
I knew you would. Yeah. And the prawns, too, which are the... this
huge,
is a dilemma.
Huh?
When a shrimp is that big, it shouldn't be called a shrimp, should it?
It's a jumbo.
Just think about it. I mean, it's a contradiction.
There's nothing shrimpy about
these
shrimp.
Nothing shrimpy. Look at these.
Yeah, look at that, Brian.
Yeah.
All dressed up, and he's into the food.
I'm
I like
you.
That. Let me put this in a nice hot skillet. Just a little bit of oil here.
This is, happens to be a cast iron skillet.
Yeah.
You're going to blacken this a little bit?
Just a little bit. You know what that jerk. Now, I told you I'd splash
it. Don't splash me. I'm wearing a tux.
I know. That's why I made you wear the apron, Brian.
So let me ask a question. Does this mean that the tuna in the can is cooked?
Yes.
Yep.
Yes.
How's it cooked?
Well, when I've made fresh tuna myself, I've done it in oil, which is so bad for you. Now they're cooking it in the water.
Oh, okay. So they kind of steam it and put it in the can.
When it's in the oil, boy, is it much better.
Well, people are surprised at the color because it's like red meat.
It's like red meat.
It turns dark.
I know it does, but when it's raw, like
fresh,
this. Yeah.
Exactly. Now what I've got here, I don't want to cook it too much. So Brian, I'm going to have you flip it for me, and that's why you've got your apron on it. And what I wanted to talk about today was mixed greens. The greener the green, the better it is for you. There's more vitamins
Is that right?
Yes, iceberg. I'm sorry, Linda. There's nothing in it for you.
No, that's true.
Get the rich greens. Right. Get yourself. I've put on there arugula mash. What I've got here is spinach, endive, a bit of the radicchio, the Belgian endive as well. So what I want you to do, the greener the greens.
The greener the better.
And use some hearty greens. Mm-hmm. Okay. And let's do a nice vinaigrette while you flip this.
Okay,
go ahead, Brian.
I shall.
My vinaigrette, what I've chosen, I'm going to use a rice wine vinegar. And if you're watching yourself, you'll find that the rice wine vinegar, if you get the season, mm-hmm. you don't even need oil. Just try it someday. Ooh. Just try rice wine vinegar.
That's great
vinegar.
Because we're also washing our fat. You hate to even add the oil to the salad, even though you're only using one or two tablespoons.
If you use the vinegar, you'll find it has such good flavor. I do it at the restaurant all the time. So what I'm going to do is just add a little bit of the rice wine vinegar.
Right into the bowl.
A bit of my oil. I use a canola oil. And I've got here ginger juice. Have you heard of ginger juice?
Ginger juice.
Well, I don't want you biting into a piece of ginger. If you do, it almost tastes like it's so strong, like perfume. Okay? So what I'm going to do is just wring it out into my vinaigrette.
Well, look at that. That's great.
You know,
great.
Just a little bit is all we need.
Did you start with a whole piece of ginger root?
And what I've done is I've ground it in the food processor. And there we go. It's all you need is just a bit. Did you ever bite into a piece of fresh ginger?
No.
They're going to ask you what kind of perfume you used in your vinaigrette.
Is that right?
I like that. So I like how I like that.
Better this way.
And what I've got is some fresh chopped garlic and some shallots. They're wonderful in salad dressings, and I'd recommend them highly. Of course, I'm going to use fresh ground black pepper. Mm-hmm. You can do that at the table. Mm. There we go. And a little bit of salt. Brian, how you doing?
This is doing nicely, by the way. You might want to keep one eye on this, because when it's done, I'm going to eat it.
Okay.
I'm not used to making the dressing in the bowl and then adding it to the salad. I'm so used to putting it on top of the salad.
Oh, well, in fact, we'll do that, Linda. I was going to toss it in here, but maybe I'll have a little too much, so.
This is a good idea.
Anyway, this is wonderful. And just a little bit of fresh squeezed lemon, okay?
Of course, I usually make it in a cruet. What do I know about putting it in the bowl?
Yeah, right? There you go.
It all has to go in the little jar, and that's that.
Linda, I'm using fresh lemon, and I do recommend that. Okay. Mm. Anyway, what we have now, this is all set, great. Brian.
Okay.
Pull that tuna off. If you can place it right here, and I'll thinly slice it.
And we should tell people, you're cooking over high heat, so that's why it's not taking long at all.
Mm-hmm. Yes, very, very fast. Brian, those shrimp will be done in a minute.
Yeah, they need about another minute. You're right.
Okay, I'm going to just thinly slice this. Now, remember, Brian, I do not want you to overcook this. And we'll fan this out over the salad. I've recommended it medium rare, and I stand by that.
It is medium rare.
Yes.
Can we show the color of that? Because people will think, well,
this is the proper way.
There you go. See that?
There you go.
That's the way it's supposed to be.
The proper way. So don't send that tuna back when the chef cooks it to you like that. Oh, right. Brian, that's
obviously tuna
beautiful.
Doesn't have to reach that much of an internal temperature to be all right, huh?
No. Okay. Well, sushi. That's raw tuna. So there you go. And I'm going to chop that with a little bit of vinaigrette, Linda. And Brian, you can just garnish it with the shrimp.
I think these are about ready.
And the reason why I'm doing the jerk today at the Best of Lackawanna, which is March 29th, we're going to be doing the Jamaican jerk chicken at Curly's.
Jamaican jerk chicken
at the Best of Lackawanna, which is one of the specialties.
There you go. In fact, we have some of that. You can see it right here. And it's that's Wednesday, isn't it?
That's Wednesday.
Yeah.
From 5 until 7:30, it's an extra half hour this year. We have 17 restaurants.
Wow!
17 restaurants, and I don't think you can get through them all.
Mm-mm.
Look at that.
Oh, there you... Brian, that's beautiful.
Okay,
and what I'm garnishing
take this off
with,
the heat.
You got it. It's some nice pita crisps.
Mm-hmm.
How does that look?
Great.
That looks fantastic.
Looks
what
like
a
fun.
Big meal that is.
Okay.
Turns out to be terrific. Look at that.
There you have it. Pan-seared.
Fresh jerk tuna.
Just the way it's supposed to be. And don't forget, the Best of Lackawanna is Wednesday night. Did we say hello to the mayor of Lackawanna?
No, we didn't.
Who's here today?
There she is.
There she is. Good morning.
Thank you.
She'll be presiding over the entire event.
And John's going to tell you how you can get the recipe for this, by the way. John?
Okay, Brian, got it right here. You can get today's recipe by sending a self-addressed stamped legal-sized envelope to Pan-Seared Tuna, AM Buffalo 7 Broadcast Plaza, Buffalo, New York, 14202.
For over 70 years, when they needed information, Western New Yorkers have turned to WBEN Radio. Today, News Talk 930 WBEN brings you Bill Lacey and Kevin Keenan mornings with the largest radio news staff in town. Add to that the CBS Radio Network, exclusive weather facts forecasts, WBEN traffic copter updates, and Buffalo Bills football, and you have the source for news, talk, and sports. News Talk 930 WBEN.
If you've been injured in a car accident, you deserve compensation for your injuries.
You deserve to have the best legal representation available.
You deserve justice, and justice is no accident.
It takes hard work and personal attention to your needs.
Call Celino Dwyer and Barnes if you need help. We'll do everything you'd expect from an experienced law firm, and then we'll do a lot more.
Celino Dwyer and Barnes, experienced personal injury attorneys. Call 854-2020.
Oh, my shoulder again.
Here's my Myoflex pain relieving rub.
Not one of those greasy, smelly rubs.
Myoflex made the smell vanish, made the grease vanish.
And it worked so well, it made my pain vanish.
Myoflex, the vanishing cream that helps make pain vanish.
What does it take to be a champion? You're always striving to be better. Pushing yourself to a new level. And that's what the Breakfast of Champions just did. Now, Wheaties taste better than ever. There's a better toasted wheat taste, bigger crunch, the new taste of Wheaties. The Breakfast of Champions just got better.
The double murder trial of O.J. Simpson. The confrontations. The defense versus the prosecution. News Channel 7's Jerry Giordano is the only Buffalo television reporter to bring the top story home to you live from Los Angeles on Eyewitness News.
Let's get a look at Linda's weather for today. Oh, it's nice. A high of 52, sunny, pleasant. Tonight, 30, patchy clouds, and we call that just a bit chilly.
Welcome back. Well, you know, we're all getting excited for tonight. And we all know that, of course, motion pictures have had a long and colorful history. But through the years, their posters have also developed as an art form. Our very own Eyewitness News photographer Jay Laurie was recently in L.A., and he discovered there's quite a show hanging around just the lobby.
Coming soon to a theater near you, the wonder of motionless pictures. A promise of adventure, a taste of romance. Provocation, titillation, but not without revelation. For the movie poster's appeal is no passing fancy, but a medium profound in its own regard. During Hollywood's golden age, posters were developed after a film was completed. Producers took their promotional hunches to in-studio art departments. There was no television to screen your trailer or research machine to speak for your product. Only the language of illustration. Vividly colored, finely etched, and printed upon stone lithographs, the glamorous depictions define the allure of legends.
We're at 325 here, 50 now, lead you to it here, 350 there, 350 again, 375.
They came, possessed, to possess.
2,000 yes, 2,000, she says yes.
Well, it really isn't stranger than fiction. Why collectors gather at the Los Angeles Gallery of Butterfield and Butterfield.
2,500 here.
It's the first such sale on the West Coast by a major auction house. That a large private collection like this was ever assembled is a miracle. When a theater was done with a film, the reels were sent out of town and the artwork discarded.
Well, for years, no one bothered with them. They used them for insulation under carpeting, under linoleum, between walls. People have gone to tear houses down and they've found posters just stacked up in the walls, and they bought a $30,000 house, and all of a sudden they're sitting on $200,000 worth of posters.
$5,000 by the villa.
Memories are expensive. The vintage works range in price from a few hundred to $40,000. However, the paper fans find them a worthwhile investment.
Paintings are out of the question.
Well, the art is spectacular.
You can still get in on the ground floor, and you can still get something that you appreciate and you love. You don't see anything like that today.
Tony Seiniger would disagree.
And then Ed Pressman, the producer, said something about make sure that he has a green tint to his skin.
His Beverly Hills advertising agency is an industry leader of poster design. Today, marketing campaigns are devised before and during production. The process is high tech and higher concept.
The movie is 2 hours of 24 images a second. And you're trying to distill this whole massive imagery into one single image that can stand up for a long time.
Top still photographers are enlisted to flesh out the sketchy ideas. Seiniger contends a romanticized sales pitch is no longer received.
The people that relate to the reality of photography, if it's illustrated, if it's a painting, there's an element of untruth about it because it's not the real image. That's the reason today we go for photography, because people buy reality. They want to know what they're buying before they put their money down.
Graphic artists also face limitations their predecessors never knew. There are now contractual restraints that limit head size and placement. While their work may not have the painterly charm of yesterday, there is no lack of refined craft.
And people have to realize how much thought and hard work does go into the process of making these things. And really how much different talents come to bear to make a good one sheet.
Yes, it has been a long run for the movie poster. From the Nickelodeon to the multiplex and all homes in between. Jay Lurie, Eyewitness News.
Don't forget, you can see the 67th Annual Academy Awards tonight. It starts at 9 o'clock, and it's right here on News Channel 7.
An offer without precedent. Literally, the world's greatest furniture sale at Braymore & Flanagan. All Thomasville and Broyhill, Berkline & Sealy. From the best furniture makers across America and around the world. It's all discounted 48 to 64% off the market value prices. Plus, no deposit, no interest, no payments at all for 6 full months. A whole world of savings with nothing to pay for 6 whole months. But these huge factory-sanctioned discounts won't last. This tremendous event ends Monday. The world's greatest sale, only at Braymore & Flanagan.
After the shootout on the Seneca Nation Indian Reservation, leaving 3 dead and 1 person seriously injured, Eyewitness News was first to bring you the story live. Steve Boyd reported from the scene with News Star 7, Western New York's only satellite news truck, and Susan Banks brought you updates throughout the day, including an interview with Indian leader Dennis Bowen with reaction to the crisis. This weekend and every day, when breaking news happens 24 hours a day, depend on your hometown team, the Eyewitness News team, to bring the top stories home to you on WKBW-TV, News Channel 7. Oscar night is Monday, March 27th on ABC and News Channel 7. Be a part of Buffalo's official Academy Awards gala party to benefit Shea's Buffalo Theater. Monday at Lake Club in the Buffalo Hilton Hotel. The fun starts at 8 p.m. Your $25 ticket includes live music, hors d'oeuvres, dessert, door prizes, and more. Call 837-2748 for tickets.
If you have any questions or comments for us on AM Buffalo, we'd love to hear from you. Write to us at AM Buffalo, 7 Broadcast Plaza, Buffalo, New York, 14202. You can call us at 840-7868. And if you happen to be outside Buffalo's area code, here's a free call. It's 1-800-234-WKBW. Use it.
Nice audience today, huh?
Great audience. Studios full of people.
And John was right about the comments. You want to say something nice about the show, write to Linda and me. If you got something nasty to say, send it directly to John.
That's
and he'll
right.
Open it.
John Summers,
thanks.
Here at AM Buffalo. For the last hour, I have been nursing along these little daffodils that arrived this morning.
Trying to get them to open.
This is the beginning of the Daffodil Festival, well, actually, to benefit the American Cancer Society. And as you can see, they are very tightly closed. This is the first day of the week that they will be available. So as you can see, they're just buds. But they've already opened up a little bit, I think, since we put them in front of
Where's
the lights.
Where's Ken Brown? He can tell us how to bring them along.
I don't know, but I cut the stems. I put them in warm water. We wanted them to have more of a bloom than this before the show. But the important thing is for you folks to get a bunch of daffodils. You get 10 blooms for $5. And here's the phone number on the screen. And they're hoping to raise $65,000. And it all goes to research to benefit the American mm-hmm. Cancer Society.
Hey, so come the weekend, you'll see folks out selling it. They'll be in banks and malls and some stores as well. So pick up a bunch.
Spring has arrived.
Yeah.
It's a good sign.
Speaking of things beautiful, John's in the audience this morning.
Well, thank you, Brian. Thank you very much.
Not you, John.
Not you, John. But the lady on your left, we're talking about the new Miss Buffalo.
Yay!
Absolutely. Let's give a nice round of applause for Elaine Galbo from West Seneca, our current reigning Miss Buffalo for 1995. Elaine, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Now, your talent, I understand, is opera. Is this unusual for a Miss Buffalo pageant?
I think I'm one of the first opera singers to be a Miss Buffalo.
I wanted to say that, but I didn't want to be wrong, and I thought I'd let you say it first. Why opera, and how long have you been involved in the study of opera?
Well, for about 6 years now, I majored in vocal performance at UB and then went on to graduate school at Arizona State, and so that is my professional goal as well.
Now, I'm going to ask you a question. Are you using this as a means to an end, or do you plan on furthering your career in opera?
I definitely plan on furthering my career in opera, and I'm grateful for the scholarship opportunities that the Miss Buffalo pageant provides. And I'd also just like to thank our corporate sponsors, the Coca-Cola Bottling Company of Buffalo and the Pontiac Dealers of Western New York.
Okay, what is the next step toward Miss America?
Well, right now we're preparing for June 10th when we go to Watertown for the Miss New York State pageant.
Okay, we're wishing you all the luck in the world. Thanks for being with us this morning.
Thank you.
Elaine Dalbo, West Seneca.
Another beautiful representative of Western New York.
We'll be rooting for you.
Take a quick break?
Yeah.
All right, we'll be right back.
Introducing the York Peppermint Patty Ice Cream Sundae from Friendly's. Rich, creamy, and delicious. Absolutely free. When you order any one of our chicken choice sandwiches. Or take home a whole pint. And get that Friendly's feeling inside.
Presenting Marvin the Magnificent!
Hey! Al, listen, there's just too much of these Encore Salisbury steaks for one magician. I can't make these juicy flame-broiled steaks disappear all by myself.
But you're magnificent.
I'm going to call him Marvin.
Marvin. Of course, a 2-pound family size entree.
I just can't make a family appear.
I can. Mine will appear at your place 6 tonight.
Al, I can't tackle all this Encore lasagna.
7 tomorrow. I'll bring my team.
For taste and more, it's Encore.
You may already know that the Names Project AIDS Memorial Quilt is a poignant handmade tribute to thousands who have died of AIDS. But it's also a powerful educational tool in the fight against this epidemic. Visitors learn that each panel represents a real person with a name and a history and loved ones. The quilt shows us the humanity behind the statistics. And now the quilt will be displayed locally. I'm David Ogden Stiers. See the quilt to understand, to remember, to help.
Fresh and flavored coffees, pastries, cappuccino, and espresso. Supplied to AM Buffalo and Offbeat Cinema from Solid Grounds, Elmwood and Bryant, the best coffee in the city.
How'd you like to watch the Academy Awards on a big screen TV? Well, you can. Buffalo's fanciest Academy Awards party is tonight at 8 p.m. at the Le Club in the Buffalo Hilton. Tickets are $25 and it benefits Shays. You get food, dessert, champagne, door prizes. Sounds like a lot of fun.
Yeah.
Just keep that tux on, Brian.
I was
going
to say, I'm already dressed. I won't have to change. And we should go and we'll look real fuzzy tomorrow. It'll be a short night. But anyway, speaking of tomorrow, Pat LaFontaine will be here. Saber star, Captain Rain.
We'll take a look at the authentic Oscar fashions as they happen, so to speak. We'll find out who wore what and why.
And everybody has something to say about
that's
that.
That's right.
Yeah. Also tomorrow, we have some special recipes. If you're a diabetic or somebody in your family is, we'll have some recipes especially for you tomorrow.
Yes, and some World War II veterans, everyone. Have a great day out there. Enjoy the sunshine.
See ya.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Thanks for watching AM Buffalo. Now stay tuned for Ricky Lake, coming up next right here on News Channel 7, your hometown team.
I'm Irv Weinstein. The top story on Eyewitness News is you. More Western New Yorkers get their news from WKBW-TV News Channel 7 than from any other source. Because news happens everywhere. Our exclusive satellite truck, News Star 7, is always ready to cover your hometown. Anytime, anywhere, on Eyewitness News. In Western New York, there's only one news channel. WKBW-TV News Channel 7.
At last, there's an exciting breakthrough in the medical transplant field. It's called micro-incision grafting. This new simple procedure makes other hair transplant methods seem outdated.
A Santangelo hair prosthesis is available to you now. Just call Santangelo's Hair Additions at this 1-800 number now. Consultants are standing by to answer questions right in the privacy of your own home. And we'll send you a free brochure plus a $300 check toward any of our hair replacement systems.